Hello everyone, what's up? This is Devyansh Gherge. This is the fourth lecture of Web Development course. In this lecture, we will be discussing about how to make the tables and how to take input from the input tags. Right? So let's start with it. First of all, let's make a new file over here. That is lecture4.html. Right? If you directly want to write the complete syntax without typing it, you can directly write it. Just type HTML and 5:5, it will directly print the complete statement over here. Complete syntax with the title as document. We can change the title and table tag. Okay. Here we are discussing the table tag first of all. The table tag consists of two things, rows and columns, right? If we first of all, we will be always dealing with the rows and then the columns, right? First of all, we will be making the table tag over here. It stands for the table that we are making a table inside. We will be further writing rows and columns. For the rows part, tr is defined as the tag. Tr tag is used for to make a single row, right? And td tag is used to make a single column, right? May I show you this in a paint in, right? Yeah, let's take the pencil over here. Sorry for this bad drawing. We can use this as well, right? Right. In this way we can. These are the rows over here. You can see it. Right, sorry, these are the columns and these are the rows here. Td tag over here, let's see, brush over here. The column stands for the td and row stands for the tr tag, right? Remember this, first of all, we will be making the rows and then we will be dividing it into columns, right? How we will be first of all, we will be dividing these boxes first using the tr tag, that is the row tag, and then the column tag, right? So first of all, let's code it over here. We will be using tr tag as the row tag. In this tag, we will be writing the columns, that is td tag. We will be making four columns over here. Let's make it first column name. Right. It is very much similar to the unordered list tags and as well as the order list tags, in which we used UL for unordered and then LI for each element. Right. It is similar to that as well. First we'll write the row tag, that is tr, and then the td tag, that is the column tag. Let's name it as td class. And then name it as td row number. Right. And then let's make the column, sorry, td marks. Right. This would be the first row in which it would be displayed. Let's save it and run it in the live server. Take this. See, it has printed name, class, roll number in a straight row. Right? These are the different columns which we have not given the spaces yet. Right? We will be giving the spaces further in the style part. And one thing before starting further, may I tell you, we will be making this type of the complete form by using, without using the CSS part, that color part we will be doing further. First, we will be learning how to make the tables. Then we will be making learning that how to make this input tags, the form tags. Then we will be making a complete this kind of a form with just table tags as well as the this input tags. Right? First of all, in further videos, it would be discussed about the table tag and the input tag. And then this would be coming as the project, as a practice project, we can say it. Now the real one. Right? So in further, in the next row, if we want to define it like this, that is td tag, then first let's take the name as Rahul and then td tag as class, let's say 10th. Then td roll number to be written as, let's take it 1 roll number. Then td tag again. These all tags represent to the simple column, right? Marks, let's take it 90. Right. Now let's save it and see it in the browser. You can see that it has printed under the same column. Name Rahul, then class 10th, roll number 1, marks 90. Right? You can see it completely, it was just similar. If you paste the same thing for other, then it would be same for that as well. Let's change the name. Return. You can take any number, I'm just taking any of these. Let's make 80 marks, then save it. You can see it will be printed like this in the further forms. So here we can see that the top heading part, that is name, class, roll number and marks, are of the same size as of the values given to them. We can't differentiate between them, right? If we need to differentiate, we can make them bold. It can also be done by the style in CSS part, but we can also do it by the HTML only. How we can do it? If we use the th tag instead of td tag in the heading part. That is, here td is given as th. If we give th over here, in the that column parts only, that is name, in name over here, in all these headings, if you give the th, it gets broader and bold as well. You could find the change over here. I'll just show you. See, you could see the changes. It got broader as well as bold as well, right? It tells that the asset has been working over here. It displays that it is the headings and the next ones are the values over there, right? You have to just use the th tag instead of td tag. That is, for the columns, you have to write heading. Th stands for the broader heading part. It can be used in any of the part. You can use in rows as well, or as well as in columns as well. But we mainly use in the column part only. Right? Here we can see that in the heading part, we have made them broad, like bold, right? If you want to give the spaces between them, if you want the column to be little bit bigger, right, larger in size, how we can make that? We can easily do it by the style part. But if with a style part in CSS, right? But if you don't want to use CSS, we have to do only by HTML. There is a special property named column span as well as the row span. In column span, it tells you about how much columns to be covered. If you give a single column to be as column span of 2, it would be covering the space of 2 columns. Right? Let's write the code over here and I will be explaining you. Here in the heading part, let's write it column span. Let's write it as 4 over here. So you can see that the name is coming in the 4 columns. I have given the 4, you can see it that it is coming in the 4 columns which are given single to the next values, like Rahul, 10th, 1 and 90. There are 4 columns, but the name tag only is including the 4 column space. This is how it works, that if you want to make the bigger, you can same way give it to the every single point, right? It would cover the equal distance. By this also you can give them the spaces and the column span. It is also used, as I showed you this form, that is admission form. Here also this column span is used very much. And as you can see the student info part, in this we have used the row span, right? In, like, I show you that student name, here the column span is used. I think column span is 4 here, according to the size over here. There as well column span is used. Here the where the this image part is there, its row span is used over here. Right? By like these ways we will be using these properties row span and column span over here to make the tables. And further in the next video we will be also learning about the this input tags as well. So that was all about this video. I hope you like this video. In the further videos we will be discussing about the form tags, fields chart and all that tags we will be discussing, and how to take the inputs and how to make the search bar. We will be discussing all the things in the coming part, in the coming parts as well. And then we will be also practicing some project, how to make a registration form without using any style, CSS or anything like that, by just using the HTML part. Right? So till then, thank you. Bye bye.